Let's just do this.
Oh, fuck, man.
Oh, man. Yeah, okay,
let's do this.
We've wasted so much time, man. Look, man, what I'm going to do is pull my beanie down a little bit and say, you know Smash Mouth like most people don't. You woke me up in a fever dream. I was fully right into that dream, and you said, no, this is tonight. There is no other night. Yeah. We have to talk about this song. Mm. Adam, video explain, you say to me, and I'm trying to wake up and I'm all confused. You're talking about Muggles Chicken promotions and stuff like that. How we're going to be fucking famous, yeah, and stuff. You know, get on the internet, you say. Show your face, you say. Talk about Smash Mouth, you say. And
yeah,
so,
I'm just frantic, man. Like, that's, you know, I've been drinking a lot of water tonight.
I've been here to tell you, man, that you're just too intense. You need to be more relaxed like me. You see, my persona is just, you know, like no one gets a word out of me unless I really am upset about something.
You're a wallflower. Yeah. Have you ever thought about going into politics?
Man, I am in politics. I'm currently running for the president of my own gymnasium. I've set up post-COVID gymnasium called, it's just called that, Two Thumbs Up.
Cool.
Smash Mouth. The song is called Yeah, one of my favorite songs.
Thumbs up from me.
The song itself, it doesn't even need a video clip. You could just have a picture of a dead horse just there in the background, sort of slowly rotting.
You've soaked in the song?
Yeah, no, I know the song now. Yeah, no, that's the it's the one that was in Shrek. Remember that?
Yeah,
I saw that in IMAX. You know, they filmed Shrek and IMAX using IMAX cameras. So that was amazing to see it and that kind of thing. And Eddie Murphy, man, fucking hell. I mean, what would Shrek be without Eddie Murphy as Shrek?
You know, yeah, what about Mike Myers?
Well, yeah, he played the donkey or whatever, but I mean, that's just racist, really. It should be played by a black person. That's what I figured.
Okay.
Anyway,
Smash Mouth, they're still going, like they do gigs and shit, you know.
Oh, shit. Oh man, I'm not complaining.
They do like 30-minute versions. They played in Melbourne actually.
They do 30-minute versions of that song from Shrek.
Yeah, they played in Melbourne.
Yeah, man. I could imagine that happened. When was that?
A couple of years ago.
Yeah, man, before COVID, right? That fucked the Smash Mouth.
Smash Mouth. Have you heard of this new one called Monkeypox?
The new Smash Mouth album. Yeah, no, I didn't.
Oh, no,
really,
it's
like
not a band.
It's
a new pandemic, possible pandemic.
Oh, you mean like they're going viral or whatever?
Yeah, it's totally gone viral. Like this, two cases so far in Australia.
Of what? The new Smash Mouth album? There's two people who bought it. That's too many. I mean, that's the thing, man. Since COVID came along for a start, I started to notice that people die. And the people that seemed to die the most were people who were, say, like 94 years of age, for example. I heard of a lady dying of COVID at 94 in an old person's home. And I just thought, what the fuck's happened, man? Like, I was going to put cyanide in my children's drinks. I just thought, no, this is it. This is, if you can't even live to be 94, what the fuck is the point? That's what I thought.
Yeah, well, we shouldn't get too political, right? Because we're just here for a good time, not a long time.
This isn't politics, man. This is all, this is what Smash Mouth is all about. The band itself, the name, the song.
And
yeah,
the singer, if you watch the clip, he wears awesome sunglasses. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get the show on, go, yeah.
Look, man. Fucking
but I didn't
Mouth.
Prepare my facts. Like, you didn't give me time to prepare the facts because you were like, let's go.
Right. Yeah, no, you're right. Well, what facts did you manage to glean? You put it
well,
back
I didn't,
on me.
Because I had about 30 seconds, but hey, I thought I'd just go on Wikipedia right now.
That's not the story that talking. I've been sending out. I haven't been tweeting this shit. What I've been saying is the opposite of that. It was that you pressured me into this. And so it's your fault because you should have, as a Smash Mouth fan, have all the facts. You should have lived their life.
But Google's rotted my brain, so I can't memorize anything.
That's fine. Well, look, that puts us on an even par because I know I saw Shrek, like I said, in IMAX, and you can see things in IMAX that make you think that you've gone to some other universe, you know. And at that point, Shrek just seemed like the realest thing that I'd ever seen. I mean, I knew it was apparently digitally created, but to me, that was like seeing a train coming to the station for the first time, like seeing film. It was basically the start of cinema for me. That's when I started getting interested in films, was when I saw Shrek. And then the Smash Mouth song, I'm trying to speak properly here. You know, I've been having elective surgery on my head. And you were telling me, well, you honestly, you haven't stopped talking to me about this Smash Mouth thing.
So positive. It's like, you know, when you drink too much vitamin C, you just, as a doctor said to me, you just piss out the rest. Like, you only actually need about this much vitamin C.
You just went red then. You're talking about pissing out fucking vitamin C, man.
Like disco ball. But no, if you drink this much vitamin C.
No, no. If you piss out vitamin C, you die. That much. That's what Carrot Head told me. Carrot Head, whatever. Hey?
Well, that Smash Mouth song is about this much vitamin C.
Yeah, man.
But you only need about that much.
Jeez, you're an asshole.
So your brain just overloads with vitamin C and pisses out your mouth.
I just don't get why you think I'm intense. And you're telling me about this stuff, about things. It sounds like a Cronenberg film about vegetarianism. It sounds like a dirty joke that I'm not privy to, but I feel shamed and uncomfortable.
It's a metaphor. And a metaphor is a secret.
Well, a lot of them are.
But just let me flick through Wikipedia. Here we go.
Yeah, right, man.
Facts.
I'm going to get fucking comfortable for this.
So it was released in 1999, which makes it 23 years old.
Yeah.
And I was in the film Mystery Man, which was a total fucking flop. I don't know if you've seen that.
Mystery Man?
Yeah.
That's the one with...
It's about, like, superheroes.
All right. I thought it's about the recording of Unforgettable Fire, the U2 album. But I've seen some comments. Well, I mostly watch people commenting on other things. I don't actually have time to watch the original thing.
Yeah.
Also,
here's me sounding smart, but I'm just reading off the screen.
Is that distracting? I'll change it a bit more mellow.
Okay.
Yeah, man, play it down, Smash Mouth.
Yeah, cool. Smash Mouth. It's a bunch of dudes, like us cool guys in the film clip. The guy wears sunglasses.
Oh, yeah, well, we haven't seen it yet. Can't wait to comment on it.
Looks like he enjoys a meat pie. Did you write that yourself?
No, this is this is the introduction to Smash Mouth. I mean, the lead singer, what's his name? I thought his name was Giuseppe.
Johnny Cockbrick.
Giuseppe Cockring.
Johnny Cockbrick.
Cockbrick? Jesus Christ. I think you're making this shit up. I think his real name...
No, it's all on Wikipedia, man.
Well, tell me his real name's Terry Cockbrick.
Johnny Cockbrick.
Pretty soon. Johnny Cockbrick. Oh, that's nice.
It's actually one of the most streamed songs ever.
Well,
according to Wikipedia. What do you mean?
What's the song called? As far as I know, it's called Yeah. And it was on the Shrek soundtrack. Oh, All Star. That's right. Yeah, you're an All Star something. Yeah.
Get the show on. Go game.
It was also in Goodfellas as well.
They had other hits.
Who did? Smash Mouth?
They covered Neil Diamond, I'm a Believer. And they had a song called Might As Well Be Walking on the Sun.
Mazel Tov.
And I this is one of my favorite karaoke songs.
You got all the facts, man. You got all the facts about Smash Mouth. You got it all, baby.
Someone put some water in my vodka.
Man, I don't know what's happened, man. Someone is trying to kill you. I mean, if you watch the front bar, you think drinking's legal in this country. Alcohol helps you. It helps you relax. It helps you relax into doing really good things. The police will tell you every Friday, you give a bunch of ordinary people heaps of alcohol and you see everyone just sort of, you know, harmonizing in a way that's just unnatural without alcohol.
If you have 8 beers, you can drive really well, I've heard.
Well, you're certainly not as scared about it.
10 is a stupid amount of beer, but 8 is just perfect.
10 is, yeah, well, that's about right, man. You know the ratio. And that's, how, I mean, your alcoholism, yeah. I would attribute to having taken on trying to understand anything at all about this band Smash Mouth that you keep obsessively harassing me and asking me to, you know, join you in it, some sort of tribute to them. Then you try and make it sound as if you were the one that was, you know, put on the spot, struggling to come up with facts, but you're just hiding the fact that you are one of their biggest fans and you've been following their artistry since they were in college. You know, when Smash Mouth used to be known as
I've been going to Smash Mouth Therapy. It's just, Smash Mouth Anonymous.
Well,
it's like, you know, if you only listen to All-Star every day.
Yeah, you shouldn't tell people about it. If it's anonymous, that's, you know, it's between you and Jesus.
Yeah, but remember, I'm not really Dan Cross. Can you put it on now? Because I'm like hanging. Yeah, man.
Well, you lead the way, man. I'm going to just, try and put this clip on. It's on now.
We just got, here we go.
Oh, here we go. So what happens? So the guy from Fargo is talking to some beautifully, he's got really nice hair. Oh, and that's Clint Mansell. He made the soundtrack to Requiem for a Dream. There's a boy from the... That's Ben Stoller there, too. This is from that film, Shrek. Have you seen that film, Shrek?
Is that the one?
Yeah, Ben Stiller. And then there's, what's his name, Ronnie Wood? No, not Ronnie Wood. The bass player from the Stones. He's a butler. And then there's this guy. Yeah, this guy. I remember him.
He's the singer.
Yeah, that's
cool,
the singer.
That guy.
Oh, no, he's definitely... he used to be in a Nazi band called Cunts, My Friends.
I can't hear the sound. Is that...
No, you're not meant to. No, we'll dub it on the laser.
Copyright.
Well, Smash Mouth wants a lot of money. If we play this...
I can see it.
This guy here, he's hungry, man. You might think he's just sitting back eating bacon every day, waiting for God to give him a second lung. But he's just... He's not waiting. He wants more money.
See, he rescues the people from a fire.
Oh, yeah, he does. You're right. And he's talking to that robot dog, Chumps. He's in the 80s film. That's his two sisters who got to be in there. Of course, back to the time of Shrek. Then, there's two lesbians gyrating on top of a chopper. And what's this guy's name, though? Look at him.
Like I said, his name's Johnny Cockblock.
Yeah, well, I think he's got charisma, this guy, Johnny Cockblock, or whatever you're saying. The way he dominates. Look at that. He's not afraid to put his face right into a fisheye lens.
No.
I mean,
also, he's proving that he's not gay.
Oh, my God.
And by having the ladies in the car.
And there's the Batmobile, and then he's back again, and he's kidnapped two lesbians, and he's going to obviously, you know, charm the pants off. And then, look, Ice-T's in it. Look at him. He's a lot skinnier and whatnot, but Jesus Christ, look at those moves. And then Smash Mouth saying, Jesus, I don't think we could dance like that. Then the Mystery Men crew come out to tie into the film Shrek. The gang from Shrek come out, tied in with Marvel. And there's Zoolander 2. And then that's Jim Carrey, I'm pretty sure, taken off there. And then now they're at what is this? The Mini Mole. And it's just back home to the caravan. What is this about, though? What is this song about?
What is this about, is what I've been saying.
Legs. And then I just don't know this guy's name. I don't know anything about this band. I can't explain anything. Tell me more, Dan. What the fuck is going on?
Well, especially in for generation.
It's something. Look at that.
It's about like positivity. Which was very popular in the late 90s.
Popularity was way more important back then, you know. I mean, this guy, he just wanted to fit in. He was just so shy. And they just put a camera in front of him. And next thing you know, he's doing Hey Now. And look at him, man. He just wants to give cuddles to kids.
He doesn't even need a microphone.
No, he doesn't. We don't even need to hear the song. He just wants the performance. Look at that, just slapping it out. I mean, the band themselves, what they called again? Smash Mouth. I mean, somewhere between Velvet Underground and Brian Jonestown Massacre.
And I mean, his real name's Stephen Dixner.
And he looked up to Lou Reed, and that's what that song, Hey Now, is about. It's about looking up to people, your idols, and then doing stuff that's nothing like it. It's up there with Who Let the Dogs Out to me in terms of something I want played at my funeral. You could meld those together, you know, go from Hey Now to Who Let the Dogs Out, and then just shove my body into a microwave and just blow it up.
This is something to masturbate over while you're eating soggy Weet-Bix. I'd suggest people, like, after they've given us a thumbs up and a subscribe, they just head straight to this clip that's got like a billion views. Take off all your clothes and just dance. Well, you know, is glass half full or is it half empty? You know, man.
Yeah, man, I couldn't hear anything.
Full of piss.
Really? Oh, you're going to sing it?
Yeah, I'm going to sing it. You're going to play it. It's going to be awesome.
Okay, ready?
Somebody once told me the birds carry on in the ink shops to a chair. She was looking kind of dumb in the mirror and the ball in the chair of the air. Years start coming and they don't stop coming. And who knows when they hit the ground running. Didn't make sense, nothing in the world was great. Hey now, you're an old star. Get your game on, all the way.
You're an all-star.
Get the just show on. So, yeah, let's put that up on Spotify.
Smell you later, man. It's been real. Love your work.
Video X Plan.